Welcome back to Yoon Consulting. I spent 5 years as a consultant and project manager with McKinsey.
Today's video is about BCG.
Alright, do you like this better? Indeed, today we talk about how to get into the Boston Consulting Group or BCG. I published this video today because last week I noticed a post of interest for you on the official BCG LinkedIn account. BCG announced that Business Insider ran an interview with Amber Graywall, who is BCG's Global Chief Recruiting and Talent Officer, in which she shares her official recommendations on how to get into BCG. BCG also attached a few summary slides to the post, but I wanted to dig deeper, so I asked for a link to the full interview. To my great surprise, big BCG with its 3 million followers got back to me, providing me with the link. Thank you, BCG. I put the links to both the post and the article into the video description. Unfortunately, the interview article is behind a paywall, but of course I got you covered and will in this video reveal and interpret for you Amber Graywall's recommendations on what to do to get into BCG. For the record, Amber Graywall is the global head of talent and the global head of recruiting of the Boston Consulting Group. She joined BCG 2 years ago as a managing director and partner, and before that has been working already for 20 years on talent management in leading US companies. Now, let us discuss what she has to tell you. Most remarkable, I found a statement at the beginning of the interview. Out of the roughly 1 million applications the Boston Consulting Group receives annually from around the globe, about 99% of those become rejections. Still, the remaining 1% equates to 10,000 new hires each year. Wait, really? BCG states it receives 1 million applications per year and hires 10,000 new employees every year? Some of these numbers do not add up for me. Let me tell you why I'm confused. In my Christmas video on McKinsey Secrets, I had digged out these figures for you. Now let's open the first one. Number 1, McKinsey hiring figures. The article reads, McKinsey gets the cream of the cleverest kids from college and business school. 201,000 applied last year for 2,200 places. This obviously relates to consulting applications worldwide, and a little maths leads to the conclusion that the admissions rate is around 1%. So let's run a comparison here. McKinsey has 31,500 employees. It is said it receives 200,000 applications per annum and takes in around 2,000 new hires every year. BCG has 22,000 employees. It is said it received 1 million applications every year and accepted around 10,000 new hires. Now, it's not absolutely clear if the hiring figures refer to consultant jobs exclusively or also include support staff, but in any case, in terms of manpower, McKinsey is 50% larger than BCG. Given that it may also be just an edge ahead in terms of reputation, that's just what the rankings say. Check this video. I find it hard to believe that BCG receives 5 times more applications than McKinsey. To pull in a fun alternative metric here, my so far 2 most watched videos provide advice to you on how to pass the first application step, the consulting online tests. At McKinsey, you need to pass the McKinsey and Bellows game to be advanced to the personal interview stage, and at BCG, you need to pass the BCG online case. I published both videos roughly at the same time about a year ago, and the McKinsey and Bellows video has so far been watched 3 times more often than the BCG online case video, which provides another piece of evidence to me that McKinsey probably receives more applications than BCG. Also, if you consider average job tenure rates, having 10,000 new hires every year would mean that an average BCG employee stayed with BCG for only 2 years. I doubt that. Yes, I know there also is an issue with the reported churn rate of that other company, which I did address in the previous video. Hence, BCG, in case you are watching this, I think it would be really great if you were able to clarify your annual application received and hiring figures, because it is obviously relevant to know for BCG applicants how great the opportunity is. What I deem is absolutely realistic is that at both companies, the acceptance rate amounts to a meager 1%. Therefore, let's check the recommendations offered by Ms. Gravel on how to get into BCG. The firm looks for talented, humble, impact-focused people who share BCG's purpose and values. Now, at first, you may tend to discard the statement quickly for appearing overly generic, but to be honest, I want to point out a knowledge nugget in there for you. Yes, of course, BCG wants you to be talented and outcome-oriented, but may the word humble come to a surprise to you? Overconfidence or even arrogance can pose a problem if you are a young graduate with top grades and fantastic experience under your belt and ready to conquer the world. If you come across as overambitious or even slightly narcissistic, though, that is a no-go for consulting firms. BCG wants you to integrate yourself into a team, and the client prefers to deal with consultants who are down to earth. Take this piece of advice to heart. The BCG Head Recruiter also offers an important clue on your business case interviews. Candidates go through a case interview that is all about looking at how they think. It's not really about what's the right or wrong answer. We would like to see how people are thinking about it. This actually contains a solid piece of advice. I do not go deep on case interviews in this video, but one of the common beginner's mistakes is that if you get dealt a business case, many of you get stressed and try to jump to some solution fast. However, even if you immediately guess the right solution, it will not help you. In order to master your consulting interviews, you need to hone your case structuring skills as a priority. More on that in the future. Going back to the article, the BCG Head Recruiter also says in the interview, make sure you subscribe to the UN Consulting YouTube channel and like this video. Oh wow!
Are you joking, my friend?
I'm 100% sure she said that. What I find interesting is that Amber Gravel attaches great importance to the final part of the job interviews, namely the part where you as an applicant get the opportunity to ask questions to your interviewers who are BCG consultants. The Q&A part of the interview between candidates and interviewers is also important because interviewers want to make sure candidates have the ability to ask questions. Now again, I like what she points to here. At the beginning of a new consulting project, you often know very little about the problem, the industry, the people. At the same time, you need to get quickly up to speed and need to ask smart questions to your team members, your clients, and so on. Hence, asking clever questions aids to your survival. In the interview, the head of BCG Recruiting goes on like this. BCG looks for a candidate's curiosity and whether they did research about BCG to get to know the firm before the interview. One way to demonstrate curiosity about BCG is to ask about the firm's work on sustainability, AI, and social impact. In addition, do some research on the firm's managing directors and partners and ask questions about their growth and success at BCG. That actually is clear and actionable advice, guys. Do your homework before the interview and be able to explain why you want to work for BCG specifically and not for Bain. Ask your interviewer on BCG's work on hot topics such as digital services and check the CVs of your interviewers in advance to your interviews so that you can ask some questions expressing curiosity about their backgrounds. There is a clue in the interview that I do not find surprising but somewhat concerning. For management consulting candidates, the interview process is consistent worldwide. Interviewers look at the candidate's experiences and capabilities and they use AI and digital technology when looking through applications to match candidates to roles based on their interests and preferred locations. I think this is an euphemism for the fact that consulting firms love it when applicants put their personal data into one of their application databases. Given the large number of applications, that makes it so much easier to filter you out, for instance, by imposing required minimum academic grades. I personally always recommend that whenever possible, try to sidestep the application databases. First, they are nerve-wracking and time-consuming. I hated them myself. Second, especially if your CV is somewhat unusual. If you manage to find a way to send your CV to somebody directly, you have a higher chance that a person reads it and reduce the risk of being at the mercy of an AI algorithm. There are a few more clues in the interview, but I think I've digged out the most important ones for you. To summarize, first, the acceptance rate at the MBA companies is around 1%. Second, Be humble in your demeanor. Third, do not rush to the solution of a case. Learn to demonstrate your thought process. Fourth, show your ability to ask questions. Fifth, inform yourself about the firm and your interviewers ahead of the interviews to prepare questions that emphasize your curiosity about BCG or the respective firm that you are applying to.
This video is only about BCG, my friend.
Okay, fine. Last but not least, whenever you can, I recommend you to find ways to apply to BCG with your CV directly to circumvent the application databases. Let me know in the comments your questions and comments on BCG's advice and this video, and like and subscribe. Hey team, I think we are done for today. That was another great video. Thank you. I actually now have a bit of a sore throat. Let's have a drink.